Hey, it's Fran, again, with a new kind of theme I'm calling the Phactory, Phactory, where I'm going to be showcasing making things in my new expanded fabrication shop. And this is a project that I need to get done because, as you know, I'm moving my lab, and this table is a table that I've had in my entranceway for a long time. It's a very typical box store type table. It's all bolts together. And I want to keep it in my foyer, but the foyer in the new place is going to be quite narrow. So I have a need to change the size of this table. So I'm taking out all the screws, and I'm going to partially disassemble this table so that I can cut it down to be narrower, and it's going to be shaped so that it's just going to fit right up against the wall just inside the door of the new shop, and it's only going to be about 20 inches deep instead of the 32 inches deep that it is currently. So yeah, I'm taking out all the screws, and then after I got all the screws out, I realized it's also partially glued together, so gonna have to whack it with a hammer a bit to break the glue. And when that doesn't really quite work, I just take a nice sharp chisel and hammer into the joints to just open up the glue and pop it loose. Old school, but you know, it works. Good old sharp chisel and a few pounds with the hammer, and yeah, that glue will just snap right off. No problem. So I'm marking the table to make it 20 inches wide, approximately. And I'm going to draw a line as a guideline, just so that I know exactly where I want the table to be cut. I always also mark the side that I want the blade to be cut to, just so I can remind myself when I get actually to cutting exactly what side of the line I want to cut on. And also I make some marks because I have to cut down the side rails too, and it's not too straightforward because the way that the legs attach and everything, I had to do the subtractions and such for the lengths I'd have to cut off on the side rails so that the legs would realign once I got them bolted and glued back on. So I've already done that. And again, I'm marking the sides that I'm going to have to cut off. Now I'm just doing a double check here of my geometry, just to make sure that when I cut the table down, that everything that I have lined up on those lines is going to work and it's going to be a good fit. Always want to check it twice, cut it once. Oh, and this is Dot. Yeah, Dot lives on our floor. She's a gray parrot. And a very smart little dinosaur she is. Yeah, she says it's great. She has actually lots of words, and she knows how to coax a snack out of me. There's Scott Kipp, and reason Scott's table saw, because as we all know, the table saw's sole purpose, as the name implies, is a saw to cut tables. Which isn't true. I'm making that up, but it is kind of ironic, or just maybe fun, to be cutting up a table on a table saw. But yeah, I'm just cutting the side rails to size. And then I talked to Scott, and well, he took some time to change out the blade, because with the table we're gonna actually be cutting with the grain. So he pulled out the cross cut blade and dropped in a rip blade, and I also had him feed it through because the table's actually quite heavy. And I didn't want to mess this up. I only got one shot at this, and Scott is the master of the table saw. So thanks, Scott. If you don't know about Scott, you should check out the Wanamaker videos that Scott is very prominently in. All right, so it made a really nice clean cut, but I'm just going to go over the whole thing with some, 400 grit sandpaper, take the edge off. It's going to be up against the wall, so I'm not going to treat it or anything like that. Double check too of the fit, you know, just laying all the parts in place and making sure that it's gonna come together. And also I'm using the table legs as the guide to make sure that I get the placement right when I glue the side pieces in and screw them back in. On the one, I guess it didn't really turn out that the screws lined up entirely. I guess when they made this table, some of the screw holes were pre-drilled and some were not. And it looks, and I found out that the holes that they did for the pockets were not really done to any kind of like pocketed hole. It's like they kind of did that on the spot, so they didn't line up. And I had to make some new screw holes to get these sides secured, so it wasn't a big deal. Yeah, that's one. And I glued the other side too. Again, repeating the same way. This side I put those starters in, and just to make sure it's all lined up and shoot those screws in. I also found with this smaller screwdriver a little trick just to get a little extra oomph out of it, because these smaller hand tools really aren't that strong. So once it reached sort of like the end of its torque limit, I would just kind of give the screwdriver a little hand turn just to make sure it's properly tightened down. And I had to do some improvisations with the tools, because I don't have like a really long Phillips driver, and the one that I have is just long enough to get to the bottom of those side rails if I use my other screwdriver. But if I use my the little Milwaukee driver, it goes in a little too far, so it was a little workaround just so I could get those one type of screws in. I'm gonna mark two, because I gotta do the final glue and screwing in of this long side rail, so I'm just setting it in with a leg just to make sure the placement's right, making a mark where I'm going to have to put it. And I'm going to put glue on both sides. Yep. And drop it in. And again, I'm going to use the leg as a guide to make sure that the corner is just right, and get it in there. Again, that trick of sort of turning the screwdriver and just giving a little hand turn after it's hit the bottom. Yeah, it's my little patented trick. All right, and the last side. Same with the trick. Last two screws. All right. And that's the last of the screws for the corner braces. Now I have to go through and drive some new screw holes to support that long side rail. And I also had to put in a few screws that I took out when I was taking the table apart. There were still some screws in the corners that I didn't break the glue, but I had taken the screws out, but I'm just putting those screws back in just as a final cleanup. Then switching out the tool again to shoot these deep screws just to hold that long rail down onto the table. And because these screws are actually in kind of shallow, because the tabletop isn't that thick, after I had gotten them started with the power driver, went through with a hand screwdriver and just, again, just by feel, making sure that the torque is just right and that they're not a little too loose. Just a little final torquing down by hand. And then we're ready to put the legs on and give it a test drive. So yeah, this project, I think the total time for me to do this whole thing start to finish, it was like a little over an hour. So it's not too bad to have a custom built table, especially one that you already like and are already used to. Alright, well there it is. So I've got a nice long wall in the other side of the factory. Give it a test drive, how it's going to go in the foyer, and it's perfect. Alright, done Philly style, baby. Welcome to the factory. I'm Fran. I'll see you around real soon. Bye!